Welcome to GYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services. And for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, currently we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics. And what we do, we daily cover your two subtopics, and in this manner, in 6 days, all 12 subtopics are covered. So this process goes on and on in a cyclic manner, and we will end this only one day before your prelims exam, that is on 31st May. So your prelims is on 2nd June, and we will end this series of MCQs only one day before your prelims exam, that is 31st May. So today is lecture number 7 of science and tech. So let's see what are the MCQs in today's lecture. The first question is, consider the following about open source software. Assertion is, the government of India has proposed a ban on the use of open source software in India for official government purposes. Reason is, open source software is publicly accessible, shareable and modifiable. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you friends that the assertion is wrong and the reason is correct. So there is no such thing that the government of India has proposed a ban. In fact, it encourages open source software as it substantially reduces the expenditure of government on copyright softwares. Otherwise, it would cost government lot of money if it buys the closed source software. So that's why it encourages in a way the open source software. And it is basically, open source software is basically publicly accessible, shareable and modifiable software, which can be modified as per the needs. So it is also beneficial in terms of local needs. So it can be adjusted to the local digital requirement. So the answer is D, that is A is incorrect, but R is correct. So solution is D. So here is the explanation as I have provided to you, that it refers to something that public can modify and share because its design is publicly accessible, for example, Linux. So in Digital India process, government is favoring a policy of open source software across all central departments. So main advantage is, it basically entails substantial savings and also increase interoperability and highly customizable and secure. Also the expenditure relating to prevention of copyright infringement is not there because it is open source. Everybody can modify it. Otherwise, nearly 2 to 3% of total IT spending goes to cyber security of closed softwares. So these are the advantages. So one example of Indian open source software is BOS. That is, it is an Indian Linux. So it is Linux distribution developed by CDEC and is customized to suit the India's digital environment. So it mostly supports the most of the Indian languages like vernacular languages. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, single cell protein brings a tremendous opportunity to transfer world's agriculture. How is it advantageous over conventional food production methods? First, considerably less land use. Second, global greenhouse gas emissions reduction. Third, low water footprint. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friend that basically these single cell proteins, they have opportunity to transfer world's agriculture because they are single cell microorganisms, but they provide the protein in a way similar to that of other foods. So they can substitute the other food taken by the individuals or animals. So that's why this single cell they use very less land, and their global greenhouse gas emission is also low, and low water footprint is there. So all of these are correct. So the answer would be D. So solution is D. So friends, the explanation of this question is not provided because we only provide the explanation of first question so that you can ascertain the quality of our explanation. That is, we just not follow the pattern of question and answer. We also provide you the explanation because explanation carries an important weight, because when you solve a question, after seeing its explanation, you are able to understand the topic in a more comprehensive manner. So only we here provide the explanation of first question, and in case you want the explanation of all the lectures, then you can contact us at this email ID, that is gyas21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this number, that is 8968426481. So there will be a minimum cost for the explanation PDFs, but that has been kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability as well as for the purpose source of our motivation. And in case you want to subscribe to the explanation PDFs, you can contact us on the said mail or on the said phone number. So let's move on to the third question. Third question is, detergents with straight chain of hydrocarbons are generally preferred over branched chain because, first, branched ones work only in soft water as they dissipate into fatty acids in hard water. Second, branched ones are non-biodegradable and lead to environmental pollution. So we have to choose that which of these is correct. So let me tell you, friends, that the correct is second, that is, branched ones are non-biodegradable and lead to environmental pollution. So mostly when we use hydrocarbons in detergents, so those with having large branches, they become difficult to degrade. So that's why they cause environmental pollution, and they also cause your bubbles in foaming in water. So answer is B, that is second only. So solution is B. So let's move on to the next question. Next question is, free radicals are formed naturally in the body and play an important role in many normal cellular processes. However, at high concentrations, they can be hazardous to the body. Which of these substances neutralizes free radicals, thus preventing them from causing damage? So we have to choose the correct answer. And let me tell you, friends, that these free radicals, they are very important for the body, but in large concentrations, they can be hazardous. So to neutralize them, basically the thing used is antioxidant. So the answer is B. So antioxidants can be both endogenous or exogenous. So they can be produced in body itself, or we can get them from outer dietary sources like grains and other diet sources like fruits and vegetables. So answer would be, solution is B. So let's move on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following about blue-green algae is correct? First, they are heterotrophic microbes. Second, they can add organic matter to the soil and increase its fertility. Third, they can fix atmospheric nitrogen. Fourth, they make up a portion of phytoplankton in many water bodies. Fifth, some of them produce toxins in aquatic bodies that can be harmful to human health. So we have to choose the correct statement. And let me tell you, friends, that all the statements are correct except one, and that is the first statement. So blue-green algae are not heterotrophic. They are autotrophic. So they produce their food themselves. So they are a kind of bacteria, cyanobacteria. So they are totally not bacteria there, but they are more close to bacteria. So they can also fix atmospheric nitrogen like anabina, and they make up a portion of phytoplankton also in many water bodies. But let me tell you, they do not play a dominant role in the food chain, because they can be some phytoplanktons can produce toxins which could affect the human health or the animal health. So the answer would be second, three, four and five only. So the answer would be B. So this is about your fifth question. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following statements. Photobioreactors provide a controlled environment for, first, high productivity growth of algae. Second, enrichment of nuclear isotopes. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. And let me tell you, friends, that the correct statement is first only, that is, high productivity of growth of algae. So basically, bioreactors are a kind of controlled environment mechanism for the high productivity of algae. So you can see the paddy fields, they are a type of artificial photobioreactors. So the answer is A, that is one only. So let's move on to the next question. Next question is, among different algae, yellow algae, brown algae, green algae and red algae, the red algae is the most likely to survive in the deep ocean waters. Which of the following is correct reason behind it? So here we have been asked that which of the following is correct reason. First, they do not require sunlight to manufacture their food. Second, they survive entirely by recycling sulfur compounds which are abundant in the deep ocean. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let me tell you, friends, that the correct statement is second, that is, they survive in the correct statement is none of these. No statement is correct. So sorry for mistake. And so the answer is D. So basically, red algae survives because the red light is available to the deep levels of the ocean, because red light has short wavelength and it does not get dispersed in and and it reaches your lower parts of the ocean. So the red algae, that's why they survive in deep ocean. So the answer is D, that is none. So this is the solution, and let's move on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following exemplifies the biological relationship of mutualism? So friends, you might know that there are different types of relationships like commensalism, mutualism, parasitism, amensalism. So here we have been asked that which of the following represents mutualism? A, humans and bacteria that lives in the intestinal gut of humans. B, cows and tapeworms attached into the intestines of cows. C, relationship between ranunculus and whales. D, all of the above. So we have to choose that which of the following represents mutualism. So let me tell you, friends, that the answer is A. So that the bacteria in the gut, intestinal gut of the humans, it but they get food from the humans, and in turn they help in the digestion of the food itself. So the answer is, solution is A. So basically, there all the relationships we have provided their explanation in our explanation PDFs. So in case you want to subscribe, you can contact us. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is ninth question. Which of these is are a major obstacle for radio wave propagation by space waves? First, curvature of Earth blocks signals transmitted from small antennas. Second, space waves cannot be transmitted without the use of geostationary satellites. So we have to choose that which of these are correct. Let me tell you, friends, that space waves are basically those waves that transfer in a single line. So the obviously then they it is not necessary for they cannot travel without the use of geostationary satellites. If they travel in straight direction, then they can travel without the use of geostationary satellites. So second is clearly wrong, but yes, first is correct, because basically if there is a kind of antenna that is smaller than the smaller in size, then obviously the space waves that come they might be blocked by the by some earth block due to its being in the shape of a sphere with a proper curvature. So answer is A, that is one only. So solution is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, what do you understand by bioleaching? First, it is an in situ remediation technology that uses microorganisms to biodegrade organic constituents in the groundwater system. B, it is extraction of metals from their ores through the use of living organisms instead of using harmful chemical substances. C, it is the decomposition of organic matter into compost by aerobic bacteria and fungi so that it can be used as fertilizer. D, it is the modification of the environment to stimulate existing bacteria capable of bioremediation. So we have to choose that which of these is correct about bioleaching. So let me tell you, friends, that the answer is B. So basically, sometimes we need the metals from their ores. So in place of the using harmful chemical substances, sometimes living organisms is used, and that process is called bioleaching. A is not a case of bioleaching because it is basically a case of bioventing and not bioleaching. And C is a case of composting. C is the case of your composting, and D is the case of your biostimulation. So answer is only B, that is solution is B. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then please do hit a like to it, and also ensure that you share it with your friends, and also do not forget to subscribe to our channel, and also ensure that you subscribe you press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important updates that we do on our channel. So in case you want to subscribe to the explanation PDFs, you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveias21@gmail.com, or at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So this is our contact number and this is your email ID. So in case you want to subscribe, you can contact us. Obviously, there will be a minimum cost for it, and as I have said you, that it is as minimum as possible for the purpose of your affordability and for the purpose of our motivation. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. Thank you. Have a very nice